Here we go again with the Tradermo Show with Matthias and Sebastian.
Happy Friday.
Happy Friday. Yeah, Matthias, how are you today?
I'm fine because it's Friday, of course. The weekend is facing me. So.
You already seem like dressed for the party?
No. That's the office look.
The office look. Very, very nice. You could be straight at Wall Street. In the old days, in the 1920s, yeah. In the little traders days, like our mobile game.
Yeah, the golden 20s.
Yeah. Okay, let's take a look at the markets. Let's just start first by taking an overall look at the market. The S&P did not make a new high today, but it really did make a nice move yesterday. So yesterday made a new all-time high, the S&P, and today, like small pullback. We had the non-farm payrolls today.
Yes.
How were those? I actually didn't have time to follow them.
I wanted to ask you how it was, so I didn't check it.
Okay. I just checked afterwards if the market had reacted in a major way, and it seemed like a non-event. So that's why, I haven't checked the details.
Yeah, I agree. So it was most likely a non-event because the S&P and the gold and the bonds are almost not moving today. So
gold, this is Euro dollar reacted a bit. If I open that here, we had a move to 116.8, right, let's open it. Here we go. We were down to 116.7 was the low, but now we are again at 117.2. So not a dramatic day also for euro dollar, but our short here working very, very nicely.
But the 117 is a strong support level. Yeah. So, but I'm pretty sure we will see this level broken next week.
So let's
stay short. Take profit then.
Okay. Then, today's topic, we have two nice breakouts in the markets. I mean, there are many, many breakouts right now because the great stocks, they celebrate new highs when the market is doing well. And let's take a look at a few of those. So first one, not a proper breakout here, but it's just phenomenal how the volatility of this stock. I mean, we're talking about Editas here again, so human genetics company, and we've seen a new local high here, not an all-time high, but a local high, going up to 26.75, then a complete sell-off down to 23, so almost basically 10%. And I know this because I have the stock, and it doesn't feel great when you look at it and it looks like this. Then the day after, it reverses completely and goes up to above 25 again, and today 25.72, close to testing this local high again, after which we might see the real breakout. So not a breakout yet, but might be one. But if you want to see a really nice breakout, then let's take a look at this one. The Trade Desk, one of the leading companies in the space for programmatic advertisement, so basically developing nice ways to buy advertisement online and offline and bringing it all together in one platform where you can bid for this. Yeah, phenomenal breakout.
It's an amazing run.
Yesterday still below 60 and today 64.65 right now. It's right now it's my largest position based on this price action. I was invested before, and also with our account here, you can see we entered it down here at 55. And today I have increased the position because of this breakout.
It's also called scaling in.
Yeah, scaling in. That's that. But we also wanted to discuss one reversal. And that is gold. But maybe before we do that, one question that probably many people have about a breakout is, when do you enter when there's a breakout? Because, you might be entering at the high, then there might be a pullback, and then you might become insecure. So, entering at at this level can still pay off, because a breakout, usually if you look at how it happened here the last time and it went from 40 to 55, it went over 3 days. So it can still pay off to go in now, but of course this is not a recommendation. You have to make your own judgment and you have to be convinced, because when you enter during a breakout, then you have to be able to deal with it when the pullback comes. And you mm-hmm. go from maybe tomorrow and the day after it still goes up, but then the pullback might bring it back below today's entry level if you enter right now. And that is then the tough moment psychologically. That's why you could maybe try a scaling in approach during this breakout and first start with a small position and then add to it if it continues up with another continued breakout, or basically on a pullback.
Yeah. Well done. Good explanation.
Okay. Well, if the master says it, then I'm proud myself too.
Come on.
Then let's look at the reversal and our worst position in our demo account here, because we really opened a big position, a too big position. That was basically my mistake. Matthias would never have made this mistake here in at 1,330. Now we're at 1,272 and we were down to 1,260 today. Yeah, but tell me, what does the gold rumor mill spin, Matthias?
Yeah, the rumors tell a lot of gold is rising soon. So I'm not sure if this rumor's all right, but my personal assessment is the same. So I'm happy to hear that, of course. Yet we see a nice reversal pattern in gold. If you have a look, then you can see we reached a new low. So as you already mentioned, the 1260, and now we are above 1270. So it looks like a nice long wick on the downside, and maybe we have a new higher closing price than yesterday. So this is in general a pretty good picture, and yeah, I'm pretty sure that we will see rising prices in gold, and that's also good for my account.
Okay, so this is basically then a reason to be careful in following Matthias here, because he is already invested, so he's psychologically influenced.
Yes.
Yeah, the gap is here closed. Like, you can see that at least on this date, based on this data, I don't know if this gap was real. Probably yes. I don't know. Matthias, from 1,260 in July, we've seen a jump to 1,290, and now this gap seems filled, which might satisfy some chart analysts.
Yes, that's the case, of course. Yeah.
Yeah.
And I'm really excited about the commitment of traders report, which mm-hmm. is reported today, and you can see the results tomorrow, or maybe late tonight, but I'm pretty sure European time is tomorrow. And yeah, I'm so excited to see maybe the commitments of traders. The commercials are long in gold then. For now, they are long, but not that much. And that could be change everything.
Okay. So it would be great if you can give an update on this on Monday.
Yeah.
But yeah, until then, that's it for today. And on next week, we have a lot of interesting topics coming up. One of them will be the Russell Index and more details on that. One of the favorite indices of Matthias here to trade.
Okay, have a nice weekend, guys.
Have a nice weekend. Bye.
Bye.